वेलकम टू ऑल द व्यूअर्स एंड द ऑडियंस. आवर टुडे टॉपिक इज़ द फैक्टर्स कंट्रीब्यूट्स टू द क्रॉप ग्रोथ स्टेजेस. दिस इज़ द बेस्ट इंडिकेटर टू आइडेंटिफाई योर क्रॉप ग्रोथ एट योर फार्म. लेट वी डिस्कस फर्दर हाउ वी कैन एस्टिमेट आवर क्रॉप इज़ गोइंग वेल अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंजम्पशन ऑफ देयर इनपुट्स. लेट स्टार्ट. Factors contributes to the crop growth stages. First one is the climate, second one is the seed selection, third one is the soil type, and fourth one is the irrigation, and fifth factor is the nutrient management. Let me explain a little about these factors. First one is the climate. The following factors that are the component of the climate: the temperature, ultraviolet index, sunshine hours. The temperature is that established due to the heat of from the sun, and the ultraviolet light is the responsible for the temperature. Sunlight hours is also very important, because how long it will come to your plant and photosynthesis process will be there, and it will help the plant to grow. Second factor is the wind speed. It is also important, because if there is a high wind speed in your area, then there will be more moisture losses from your plant, and if the wind speed of most of the time for the crop production is the slower, this component will not affect the in sense of the water losses. Third factor of this climate is the humidity. Humidity is also very important. High humidity is favorable only in the case if you manage the crop in a better manner, because high temperature and high humidity is also favorable for the growth of the insect and pest. The growing degree days is also important one, and I will explain this component in detail in further next stage. Seed selection. This is also very important for your crop, because the seed variety. In this context, I would like to explain that there are same crop has the two different characteristics. For example, in cotton, some varieties are the tillering varieties, and they don't have the behave like a bushy structure. And when they grow, this single tine or single tiller will grow and it will bring the fruit, and the sowing pattern of this type of the seed is different. But if the seed is of the nature like it will grow like a bushy structure, so the sowing pattern of that plant will be different. Crop morphology is the study of the physical structure of the plant. So it is very important when you are selecting your seed or buying your seed, you must be aware of the characteristics of your seed, what type of the crop morphology of that seed. Soil type is also very important factor, because it is a huge contribution in the crop production. Sandy loam, silt loam, clay loam, and like we can say that I write here only three types, but scientists divided it into 12 categories of the soil type. So there is a main you can say the types of the soil mentioned here. Sandy loam component, you can say it water holding capacity of the sandy loam soil is less comparative to the silt loam. Silt loam is little better, and clay loam has the much better water holding capacity, and it is also favorable to the crop growth and water input cost, irrigation cost of that in that type of soil is lesser, and it's more profitable soil in the crop production. Irrigation, there are different type of irrigations: flood, ridge, or bed and furrow irrigation, high efficiency irrigation systems, The example of these systems are the drip irrigation, drip tape, dripper, micro irrigation, bubbler irrigation, and sprinkler irrigation. The most important factor is the nutrients management. The nutrients can be divided into three categories: macronutrients, secondary nutrients, and the micronutrients. Macronutrients N, P, K, and S. Normally, people know the NPK is the macronutrients, but S, that is a sulfur, that is also is very important, and researchers over the period now declares that you can consider the sulfur as a macronutrient because it is very important and very essential component of the chlorophyll cell in the result of the photosynthesis process. So if there is a deficiency of sulfur, your crop will not yield better. Secondary nutrients, they are calcium and magnesium are the secondary nutrients. The micronutrients, they are used in the very minute amount for the crop, but without that a successful crop is not possible. So here is some example of the micronutrients: the zinc, boron, molybdenum, manganese, copper, and iron. Climate, it is very first factor, the climate composed of the temperature, ultraviolet light, wind speed, humidity. One should maintain the record of climate conditions at farm level. Nowadays commercial farms must have their own weather stations. If farm scale is not too big, then some farmers in a vicinity can manage a joint venture weather station for the well-being of the crops in the area. Importance of the growing degree days. Growing degree days, secondly, we call it the heat units. For every stage, the plant consumes the specific amount of heat that comes from the sun, and it uses only ultraviolet light, and that heat is complementary component for the chlorophyll and the other processes in the plant. Some farmers don't consider crop growth stages with respect to age, degree days of the crop. According to my observation based on my crop production experience, it is one of the best indicator that links with all the factors. Crop in charge must be aware of the available growing degree days and must have an idea which crop stage should have achieved by the crop. If field crop meet the planned crop growth, that means every component is contributing in a good manner. On the other way, if field crop don't meet the planned stage, that means either one or more component are lagging. Now look at the other contributor for crop growth. Now there is a little more explanation. When you need to understand the concept of the growing degree days or the heat units, you must aware of the lower threshold and upper threshold of the crop. These are the temperatures below which and the higher than the upper threshold temperature, crop don't perform the biological activities inside and it stops growing. Even below the threshold, lower threshold, and above the upper threshold, plant stops growing. Minimum and maximum temperature of the day, that is also a factor which is used in the calculation for the available growing degree days. We will handle this topic in some other blog in a detail. Just there are some figures to have you give you an idea. Alfalfa completes its cycle by consuming 250 to 275 growing degree days. Corn consumes 2300 to 3000 growing degree days. Cotton consumes 1700 to 2100 growing degree days. Similarly, peanut and sorghum numbers are there. Alfalfa weevil. This is very important because the growing degree days is not an indicator of the crop growth status, but is also an indicator for the insect and pest growth. So we can also estimate what kind of the insect and pest attack will be there in our area or at our farm. Plant morphology. There is a little detail of that component. It is the study of the physical structure of the plants. Farmers must be aware of the plant morphology of the crops and variety specific information. Cotton has single tiller as well bushy structure variety. Plan your sowing according to the variety specific recommendations. Green pea has vine type and the bushy type of varieties. Each crop has specific information can be obtained from seed supplier as well agri extension departments. Soil characteristics, those affect the plant growth. The soil porosity, water holding capacity, soil texture, soil structure, chemical properties of the soil, pH, organic matter in the soil, inorganic matter in the soil, soil chemical reactivity and colloidal properties. Soil porosity is necessary because it needs for the gases exchange in the root zone for good growth. Water holding capacity, that links with the texture of the soil. Texture of the soil is the proportion of the different components of sand, silt and the clay. Soil structure is also very important, because if this is a prismatic or the bulky structures, so there will be more complex detail of that topic. The soil structure we will cover in detail in some other vlog. Chemical properties, pH, that is the power of hydrogen ions. It is measured on a scale from 1 to 14. 7 is the neutral value. Below the 7, your soil medium will be the acidic, and if the value is more than the 7, it means your soil media is have the basic nature. Organic matter in the soil, it is also very important. Inorganic material, that is the rocks and the minerals, and further it undergoes the mineralization process and that nutrients available to the plant. Soil chemical reactivity, that is the also depends upon the inorganic or organic materials inside the soil and the fertilizer reactiveness to the water, and what type of reactions will be there, and either the nutrients will be available to the plants, either they will block in the soil, they get a form which is not available to the plants. Colloidal properties, that is a soil property by which it behaves like a improved water holding capacity. Irrigation scheduling, it is also very important. There are two cases, under irrigation and the over irrigation. Under irrigation, it is the case when photosynthesis slows down and it happens. Why? The main reason is when there is under irrigation, the nutrient availability and the water availability to the plant becomes scarce, and the biological activity inside the plant reduces, so the growth also becomes slower. Immunity reduces to the sustain with harness of the climate and other influences. The most critical is the sap of the plant taste becomes more favorable for sucking pests to attack. At this point of movement, new task of insect and pest control adds to your plan. Over irrigation, this is also a very critical stage for your plant, because if you in your field there is a prolonged flooding, ponding of water more than 48 hours, the oxygen will deplete from the root zone and the plant will go to the permanent wilting point, and you can say that in simple words your plant may die. So within 24 hours the flooding in the root zone should not be there, and the saturated soil is a very poor condition for the growth of the soil. During the saturation process, the plant will not uptake the nutrients from the soil. Fertilizer plan. This is three, you can say, the formats by following which you can plan your fertilizer for your crop. Best way to plan the fertilizer is that plan should be based on the soil analysis report, what kind of the nutrients the soil has and what we need to add. Second option, if we don't have the soil fertilizer soil analysis report, then we should follow the general fertilizer recommendation plan and modify according to the crop growth stages. Third one, this option plan can be formulated on the history of your field, can also assist you to formulate a better plan your last crop growth and yield. While formulating your fertilizer plan, soil type, sand, silt, clay proportion must keep in consideration. Moreover, also consider organic matter content in your soil. Organic content is primarily responsible to produce humus that affect positively bulk density and improves the water holding capacity as well. Humus also rich in nutrients, likewise abundant nitrogen, and farmer can plan accordingly. In case of the shortage of the organic matter in your field, parallel to other considerations, also consider fertilizers rich in sulfur, because soil without organic matter don't have sulfur, which is produced during the decomposition of organic matter. Years before, NPK was macronutrient in farming, but researchers have found sulfur is as much necessary and include this in the category of macronutrients, and nowadays NPKs are considered as macronutrients. At closing this block, many points need explanation, will be delivered in future Agri Services block. So please subscribe our channel and hit the like button. Your subscription and watching this full length of this vlog is a token of encouragement for us. Thanks a lot.